Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. What we have today on the test bench is this Vigier Supra A. That is two A's, and the second A stands for Amber Pickups, which are brand new for 2017 on the new line of Vigiers. They're a handmade German pickup, and they're made specifically for Vigier guitars, which is very cool. We'll talk more about those in just a second. Those of you familiar with the Excalibur will know kind of a bit about this already. It's very much a high performance guitar for the high performance guitar player. It's a beautiful instrument, feels really, really cool. Let's look at some specs and then we're going to talk tones. So, beginning over here at the headstock end, what you can see is, of course, the lovely Vigier logo. There's our Excalibur. The first thing that will become apparent to you, hopefully we can get this on camera, are these two teeny tiny little fellas down here. These are called the Flex Retainer, and they are, as it initially appears, a string ball end, no less. Now, I really like this. Apparently, I was just talking to Ben from Vigier, apparently, originally they were gonna make a metal insert that was gonna be a flexible string tree, but it got damaged. And to kind of prove a point, Patrice put a ball end on there and everybody loved it and freaked out. So they've stuck with ball ends, which is really cool. And it actually is literally a ball end from a string. And what it does, you can see there, if I depress the string behind the nut, you can see this moves and it's kind of flexible. Now that means that there's very little friction on the string behind the nut, which improves tuning stability and it also improves the tone. Now we have six inner line locking machine heads. I'm going to flip this over so you can see the size of them. They are absolutely massive, as I'm sure you can see there. This has two effects. First of all, they're nice and easy to grab, and secondly, there's a lot of extra mass introduced, which in turn increases sustain. And because the guitar is so well balanced and the headstock is nice and small, it doesn't affect kind of neck heaviness as heavy machine heads often can. You'll also see down here, these are the two little inserts for the flex retainers. And you can actually, I'm giggling away to myself because this is really cool. You can even insert your own string ball end in here if you happen to break one of these at a gig, which is just fantastic. I think that's really cool. That's a great little innovation. So turning over, what we've got down here is this kind of string dampening device. Now, what a lot of people will do, especially, again, the high performance guitarist, if you're into, especially if you're into metal, a lot of the times kind of like effort will be made to dampen down the string vibrations on this side of the nut. It can affect the tone of the string this side of the nut. So what Vigier have done is they've kind of experimented with different materials and different amounts of dampening and came up with this little strip here, which kills most of the vibrations, but not all. So it doesn't really kind of dampen down the ringing string, but it does mean that you don't get any kind of plinking and plonking from this end. We have a nut, which is very easily replaceable, followed by a zero fret. Now, unusually, this zero fret comes in six individual pieces. And those of you who've seen my review of the Dan Electro that we did in Guitar Interactive issue 52 will know that I'm a big fan of zero frets. I really like them for a number of reasons. First of all, they improve your action height at the bridge end, and they give you kind of an increased level of consistency between fretted notes and open string notes because you have a fret against your open string notes, so they kind of sound very similar. It can also improve sustain, it can improve tone and intonation as well, which is really cool, but they do have a tendency to wear. Now what Vigier have done, which is really quite interesting, is they've got this little six-piece system, So if one of these bits of zero fret wears out, and apparently it's usually the G string, you can literally pop it out with a thumbnail or with a pick, and you can replace it with a part that is available from Vigier. And I think that's really clever. I really like that. So moving on to the fretboard, we have a lovely piece of rosewood and 24 beautifully finished stainless steel frets. Now, I can't express how much of a fan I am of stainless steel frets. I love them. I think they're absolutely brilliant. The reason they're so good is they are harder than the material of your strings, which is normally kind of a nickel steel alloy. This has a number of implications. First of all, it means the fret won't wear out over time. And secondly, because it's a harder material, it's more conductive of the vibration of the string into the neck, which kind of subtracts less of the tone, if you kind of know what I mean. It doesn't really add anything, it just takes away less, which I think is pretty cool. Like I say, they're beautifully finished, and a nice touch is if you kind of look at the fret ends here, you can see that where the fret has been inserted, they've actually filled the space with a little bit of wood, which is really, really nice. That is a nice high-end touch. Now, if we turn things around again, we have a French maple neck with carbon fiber reinforcement. And this is 90% maple, 10% carbon fiber. And this is in lieu of a truss rod. So there's no truss rod to adjust because you don't need one. If you have a carbon fiber reinforcement, the neck is basically made to have the perfect amount of relief. And you can change from kind of very, very light strings to very heavy strings. You can move to humid environments. The neck's not going to move. And because of this, they also means they can ship the guitars in tune and they don't have to take the tension off the neck. So this was literally in tune when it came out of the case, which is very cool. So going down here a little bit, you can see we have a bolt-on four bolt design, which is kind of very standard, this super strat type guitar. And we have on the front, again, we have this lovely pick guard. It's quite a small body, which for someone who's quite large like me, this kind of maybe looks a little bit small on me, but it is a nice design. It feels really good. It balances well. And as previously mentioned, we have these amber pickups, which are handmade in Germany specifically for this guitar. So all of the guitars in the Vigier range that offer amber pickups, they don't use an off-the-shelf model. They are made specifically for the guitar. And another cool thing, again, this is something Ben told me from Vigier. What they do is when they install the pickups, they adjust the pull pieces to each string on each guitar by hand so that your string balance is as good as it's gonna get straight out of the box. We have a five-way switch and we have two pots for master volume and master tone, and unusually, these are both 1 meg pots. So full open, it's basically like not having a pot in place. It's a bit like having a blower switch, which kind of comes standard in quite a lot of high performance guitars these days. It also means there's quite a severe taper, so they do have a slightly unusual taper. It's nice, it does feel good. There's no treble bleed capacitor on the volume pot, so it does get a little darker as you turn things down. Your mileage may vary with this. Personally, I'm a big fan of the treble bleed. It's a very easy mod to install if you want one. Some people don't like them. If you don't like them, great, it's not there. If you do, it's really easy to put one on. The bridge is this 2-point non-locking tremolo. Now, I'm not gonna say that the days of the locking tremolo are past, but we're seeing fewer and fewer of them purely because non-locking trems are so good these days, and this is no exception. What we have are, they're called needlepoint ball bearing edges, and they're basically like ball bearings, only really, really, really small, and they're kind of machined to be of the kind of quality you'd expect to see in like an aircraft or a Formula One car or something, so they won't wear out in your lifetime. And in fact, apparently, the bearing edges are set to last, if you do this, for 100 years on your trem, they won't wear out. And you know, I have no intention of doing that on my trem for 100 years. Anyway, another thing we have down here is you'll notice, again, in the kind of in the pursuit of reducing friction, we have kind of these roller saddles, which again just kind of reduces any friction or any points where the string could snag. And this just makes for greater tuning stability. We have a locking collar on the bar, which means we can flutter, which is kind of nice. It means we can go this way. Look at that. Really, really, really nice. And one final thing to point out is down here, we have a locking jack socket. Now, Again, it's kind of a, it divides opinion. If you are a touring artist and you use a wireless system, this is a godsend because it's going to mean you put your jack in and it is not going to come out no matter how much you swing your guitar around. However, if you don't use wireless, if you're on a cable, do be careful with that because it can cause some problems. But I think it's a good addition. I'm glad they put that on there, especially on a performance pro level guitar such as this. Now, there are the specs. Let's do some tones, and we're going to start out with a little bit of filth. But the gear we're using before we do this is we have an orange TH30 set completely clean with everything at 12 o'clock, and I'm using a JHS 80 Andy Timmons signature pedal for all of my distortion. Let's start with the bridge pickup, bit of drive on. That's what you heard in the intro. Sounds like this. Now, moving forward, we're going to go to the second position, which is, to the best of my knowledge, a split bridge humbucker and this single coil, which is kind of recessed further back. So we're going to get a bit more of this bridge pickup character. Does sound pretty cool distorted. It's a bit like this. And the middle pickup on its own. So loads of character there, really, really kind of rich and springy. Very, very nice indeed. We are going to go to position four, which again is going to be a split humbucker and this single coil on its own. And last but not least, the neck pickup all on its own. Right, so hopefully, as you can hear, these pickups have a very different character to the DiMarzios that are normally found in Vigier guitars. They're a little more kind of, I want to say vintage sounding, but they're kind of not. They're a bit more, they're still quite a modern sounding pickup, but they've got more of a kind of a full range thing going on. They're a little less mid-focused. There is a little more character in the high end, which you'd expect from a scatterwound pickup such as this. Let's try them clean and see how they sound. We're going to go in reverse order this time. We'll start with the neck pickup, turn my distortion off, it's going to sound a little bit like this. So clean, you can really hear the big dynamics available in these pickups. You can really kind of tailor your pick attack to kind of take full advantage of this, and you can hear how the quiet notes are very, very soft but very round, and as you start to dig in, a bit of that brightness reveals itself. Let's move to position four and see what happens. Cool, so a really big difference there between the neck pickup and this split position. Let's move to the middle position on its own. So a really pure voice from the middle position, really, really nice. This often gets overlooked in super strat type guitars, but I'm a big fan. I really like that, especially clean. Let's move to position number two. So a really cool, spanky, strat-like voice going on there. It is a little bit richer than a traditional kind of two single coils thing, but it really is kind of a good impersonation, especially in a pinch. Let's move to the bridge humbucker clean, and we'll see how it sounds. So while the bridge humbucker has all that kind of warm, throaty mid that you would expect from the bridge position on a guitar such as this, the extended high and low frequency that you get from these really nice amber pickups, it does kind of lend itself to clean playing better than the kind of pickup you'd expect to see in this type of guitar. So very, very impressive turn from Vigier. Big fan of this guitar, really like it a lot. You can read the full specifications in the magazine, but for the time being, I'm gonna leave that there. Thank you very much for tuning in. My name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.